Welcome to a presentation on metric unit conversions. The goal of this video is to convert from one metric unit of measure to another, and we'll be focusing on length, mass, and capacity. The metric system is widely used by most of the world because it is based on powers of 10, and this allows for easy conversion between smaller and larger units. The United States still uses the standard system. The use of the metric system has increased. Let's go ahead and take a look at length first. The basic unit of length is the meter, which is just over 1 yard. And originally, this was intended to be 1/10,000,000th of the distance from the Earth's equator to the North Pole, but in 1983, it was defined as the distance traveled by light in a complete vacuum in this very small fraction of a second. The basic unit of measure for mass is the gram, and 1 gram is the mass of a cubic centimeter of water. There is often confusion between mass and weight. Mass is the measurement of the amount of matter something contains, while weight is the measurement of the pull of gravity of an object. So as a result, the mass of an object doesn't change when an object's location changes, while weight does change with location. So if you were to weigh yourself at a low elevation versus a high elevation, there would be a slight change in the weight, but not in the mass. And for capacity, the basic unit of measure is the liter, and a liter is equal to 1,000 cubic centimeters. Okay, let's go ahead and talk about how we're going to do these conversions. What I want you to notice about this table is the basic unit of measure is in the middle, whether we're dealing with length, capacity, or mass. To the right, we have smaller units, and to the left, we have larger units. And because the metric system is based on powers of 10, a decimeter, deciliter, and decigram is 1/10 of these basic units of measure, and a centimeter, centiliter, and centigram is 1/100 of these basic units of measure. To the left, a decameter, deciliter, and decagram would be 10 of these basic units of measure. If it has a prefix of hecto, it would represent 100 of these basic units. And if it has a prefix of kilo, it would represent 1,000 of these basic units of measure. So because this is based on powers of 10, to convert between different units of measure, we would either multiply or divide by powers of 10. But an easy way of doing that would be just to move the decimal point a certain number of places to the left or to the right based upon the conversion. So let's take a look at some specific examples on how we're going to do this. If we want to convert kilometers to meters, we will first identify the given units of measure in the table and then identify the unit of measure that we want to convert to. On number one, we want to convert from kilometers to meters. So we're going from a larger unit to a smaller unit. Notice we're moving 1, 2, 3 columns to the right, which means we can multiply by 10 to the power of 3 or just move the decimal point 3 places to the right. So we start with 6.3 and move the decimal point 3 places to the right. So 1, 2, 3. Notice we did not have enough digits, so we do have to add 2 zeros to make the number 6,300. So 6.3 kilometers is equal to 6,300 meters. On number 2, we're converting 62,300 centimeters to hectometers. Let's identify those two columns. Here is the centimeter column, and here is the hectometer column. So now we're moving from smaller units to larger units. Notice we're moving 1, 2, 3, 4 columns to the left. So we could either divide by 10 to the power of 4, or just move the decimal point 4 places to the left. So we start with 62,300. Which means the decimal point would be here. Move it 4 places to the left. 1, 2, 3, 4. We have 6.23 hectometers. So as you can see, if you have this table handy and you know your abbreviations for the different types of units, the conversions are very straightforward. Let's take a look at two mass conversions now. You'll notice it'll be exactly the same idea. So we're going to identify the grams column and the kilograms column. So grams would be right here in the middle, and we're converting to kilograms. So notice we're moving 1, 2, 3 columns to the left this time, which means we could divide by 10 to the third or just move the decimal point 3 places to the left. So we start with 37,200, which means the decimal point would be there. Move it to the left 3 places, 1, 2, 3. We have 37.2 kilograms. Now we're converting hectograms to decigrams. So we're starting here and converting to here. So we're moving 1, 2, 3 columns to the right. That means we need to multiply by 10 to the third or just move the decimal point to the right 3 places. So we have 1.73. Move it to the right 3 places. We have 1, 2, 3. We're missing one digit, so we add a 0. We have 1,730 decigrams. And let's take a look at a couple examples that involve capacity or volume. Number one, we're converting liters to milliliters. So we're starting here and moving to milliliters. So we're going from larger units to smaller units. We're going to multiply by 10 to the power of 3, or just move the decimal point to the right 3 places. So we have 93.7. Moving this decimal point to the right 3 places, we have 1, 2, 3. We're missing 2 digits, so we're going to add 2 zeros, and the result would be 93,700 milliliters. In this last example, we're converting from centiliters to kiloliters. So we're converting from here to here. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 columns to the left. So we move the decimal 5 places to the left. So we start with 62,300, which means the decimal point would be here. Now we move to the left 5 places. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have 0.623 kiloliters. So that's pretty much it for converting length, capacity, and mass using the metric system. As you can see from these examples, it is very important that we become familiar with this table so we can do the conversions quickly and easily. I'm going to go ahead and end this video with a table that does do some comparisons between the American and the metric system. So if you're not familiar with the metric system, you can get a better idea of how these measurements compare. So you may want to pause the video and take a look at this. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.